Okay, here is my Compaq Evo N400c laptop. And as you can see, I'm using two external monitors. One is a normal VGA monitor hooked up right there. And then I have this old Amdek composite monitor hooked up also directly to the laptop through the composite video output that it has on the back here. The display on the composite color monitor is a little fuzzy, but it's actually readable even in 80 column mode. And compare that to the VGA monitor. That line there is because of my camera, it's not actually on the monitors. And there's the built-in LCD. Active matrix, 12.1 inch. Same size as my new ThinkPad. In fact, overall, the whole computer is pretty much the same size. As you can see, it's a Pentium-III 850. 256 megs of RAM. It supports up to 512, but I've had trouble finding memory modules. It right now has two 128s to get the 256 total, and I've tried a couple different 256 modules to get the 512, but I haven't been able to find any that actually work. Either the computer doesn't start up at all with those installed, or it starts up but it gives an error message that the memory is incompatible. So for now it just has 256, which is marginal for XP. It runs okay, but it will be a lot better with 512 or even more. It has built-in ATI video and a lithium-ion battery. It's only a 4-cell battery, so it doesn't have much life. Although it could just be because the battery is getting old. One neat thing is that video output, you can change it to PAL if you have a European TV. Or NTSC, which is NTSCJ, which is what they use in Japan. It's the same thing, but it's a slightly different calibration of the specs. So I don't really see any difference when I use NTSCJ. Then there's PAL-M, which is used in Brazil. I believe it's 525 line, just like NTSC, but it uses the PAL color system, so it's a hybrid color system they use there. So let's actually quit out of this and start it up with XP. There was the Compaq logo, maybe you just saw it on the external monitors here. Probably the only time you see Windows XP logo on an Amdek Color-I monitor. I also have the audio output going through to it. Let's see if we can get some sound on it. Alright, I have to log in here. This is actually using a flash memory drive that I put in after the original hard drive crashed on this thing. See, it uses a little adapter there to fit into the hard drive socket. It uses a standard compact flash drive there. There's a CPU fan, and that's the second memory module. The first one is underneath, under a little door, so you don't have to take this whole thing apart to get to it. And then there's, I think, the modem and the Ethernet card in this. This was built to support a built-in wireless card in here. It's like a proprietary connector, and you can get the official Compaq wireless card, but it's only the B standard, which is slow. It's not the N or the G standard. One of the things about using a flash drive instead of a hard drive is that it shows up as a removable disk. And this one seems to run rather slow. It could just because I'm not using the fastest available compact flash card in there. Or it could just because of the way it interfaces with the IDE. So it tends to bottleneck the performance sometimes. You see the light stay on continuously for like a couple seconds until it starts responding again. So I'm not really happy with the performance of the flash card on this. I mean, it works, but it's not as good as a hard drive was. Docking base. It has a CDRW drive, a floppy drive, and these are swappable for two additional batteries if you want. And I think they might have even had a zip drive for these bays. There's the eject button. It has a pair of speakers built in. It has a line in and line out audio. Which you don't see that too often on laptops, a line in instead of just a mic in. Parallel port, some kind of expansion connector, serial port, another VGA port in addition to the one that's built in, although it probably disables this one when you have the bay attached. USB 1.1, PS2 keyboard and mouse, another USB, and the power connector. And the other speaker. Here it is playing the speakers built into the docking base. Let's try to turn that up a little bit. Alright, it's already all the way up. But evidently that's as loud as it gets. Doesn't sound too bad for the size. Here's the bottom of the Compaq laptop. I think that's the built-in speaker if you don't have the docking base installed. It's a little mono speaker there. There's this, the door for the first memory bank, or actually the second one. The first one's built in. And yes, that is a valid XP product key, so please don't copy it. I don't mind if you take the Windows 2000 product key, because I'm not using that, and I don't plan to. So as you can see, when you bought this computer, you had a one-time choice between XP and Windows 2000. There's the little 4-cell battery, and as you can see, it doesn't go all the way to the back, so if they made a bigger one, it would just have to stick out like a stand instead of hanging out the back. Compaq Computer Corporation, product of Taiwan. I like the styling of this. Nice black and silver aluminum look. And they put it sideways, the logos, which is kind of different. And it's nice and small and light. About the same size and weight as my ThinkPad, although the ThinkPad has a larger battery, which adds to the weight. So if the ThinkPad had the same size of battery as this, it would be about the same weight as this. There's the built-in features there. Power switch, headphone, microphone, PC card slot, USB 1.1, infrared, Ethernet, modem, parallel serial, composite video, which you've seen, VGA, power adapter, another USB, and the fan vent. So lots of built-in ports here.